construction has been beneficial. One step closer to mastery. It's all in hand. It's clear to me now. Flattery will get you nowhere. One step closer to mastery.
It is a long road to mastery.
How long will this take?
Tell me, am I achieving anything yet?
How long will this take?
It is a long road to mastery. Oh, I was right. How embarrassing. I'm not used to such praise. Oh, I was right.
Thanks for your support.
It's all becoming clearer. I thought this was a test. All right, that's enough praise. Hey, that was useful.
Question. As good a reason as any.
You look unwell. It's because of what happened, isn't it?
don't speak of it aloud.
You can't change the past. For now, all we can do is use it to our advantage.
I know that. I also know that I must steel myself to ascend the Imperial Throne.
Those preparations are going well. Someone is coming.
Professor, I heard about our mission for this month. Something terrible is happening in Remire Village. That's where you were when fate sent you our way. This feels preordained.
Are the Knights making progress with their investigation? If what is happening there is by design, there must be someone pulling the strings. There is the Death Knight, of course, and the mysterious mages who were implicated with the Western Church. They showed up when Flayne was kidnapped as well, and now there is another strange occurrence near the monastery. It seems an unknown organization hopes to make the monastery its stage for something.
Do you believe that all these incidents are connected, Professor? That is the logical conclusion, but I'm not so sure. It certainly appears that all of the events surrounding the monastery are connected by a single thread. However, I think it's possible that it may just be a result of different motives overlapping. Remember, Professor, if you think of people as simply enemies or allies, it may be impossible to grasp the truth.
I am happy that you invited me, even though it interferes with my nap time. Much appreciated.
Makes me sleepy.
Agreed. Surrounded by all these crest bearers makes me want to better understand crestology. Professor? What's wrong? You look sleepy. Are you sleepy by any chance? Well, I am. Warms me up. This hairband? Someone gave it to me, I think. Yet if that's the case, I've forgotten who. Professor! Smells good. That was delicious. It feels good to relax. Well, I'm off to catch a nap. Let's get it done quickly.
We must give it our all. Have a look at how we did.
Let's put this to the test.
Hope this is good for something.
Technique never betrays.
Flane, I have another question for you, if you please.
Another one, Linhardt? When will you leave me in peace?
A breakthrough has been made concerning your crest. A major crest of St. Sethlene, correct?
Well, yes. I've been trying to keep that quiet.
Part of my interest on this topic is that I possess a minor crest of Sethlene myself.
I am aware.
Possessing a minor crest is uncommon, but not rare among the noble families. However, a major crest of Sethlene, that is beyond rare.
Oh, is it?
I am quite curious as to why you were born with such a rare major crest. Given that mine is a minor crest of the same type, it's possible that you and I are distant relations.
You and I related? I am quite certain that is not the case.
Oh, do you have access to a detailed ancestry? That could be a most useful tome.
No, I do not. However...
A shame. Oh, to explore one's lineage and investigate such possibilities. Alas, the odds of your being a direct descendant of St. Sethlene are quite low. The prevailing theory among respectable scholars is that St. Sethlene died having never married.
It's true she's unmarried. Was unmarried, that is. I hate to disappoint you, but I'm not a descendant of St. Sethlene. Of this, I can assure you.
While I do not subscribe to your absolute certainty, I do agree your relation to her is highly unlikely. Yet there is some connection between yourself and St. Sethlene.
What was that you were mumbling to yourself?
Nothing. My apologies. Simply thinking aloud. I do hope we can continue this discussion sometime.
He always acts so oddly. It makes me ill at ease.